extrinsic semiconductor. Extrinsic semiconductor. In the beginning, I already told you, intrinsic means pure form, extrinsic means impure form. Very simple. You take a intrinsic semiconductor. You take a intrinsic semiconductor. Say it is a intrinsic semiconductor, pure form of semiconductor. Intrinsic semiconductor. You add some impurities. Here I am adding some impurities. Impurities. You take intrinsic semiconductor, you add impurities. Automatically what happens, sir? That is called as a extrinsic semiconductor. Extrinsic semiconductor. So what is extrinsic semiconductor? That is a impure form of semiconductor. That is a extrinsic semiconductor. Here what I am doing, sir? Here I am adding. What I am adding? I am adding some impurities. Where I am adding? I am adding impurities to intrinsic semiconductor. That process is called as a, that process is called as a doping. That process is called as a doping. What is the doping, sir? Important it is. What is doping, sir? Doping process is what, sir? The process of adding impurities. The process of adding impurities. The process of adding impurities to intrinsic semiconductor. To intrinsic semiconductor is called doping. So which one you have to select to impurity? So what is the use of doping? If you dope a semiconductor, if you add some impurities, automatically conductivity increases. Automatically conductivity increases. It is the main purpose of doping. Intrinsic semiconductor accept the current, but a small current. But if you add some impurities, after doping the current increases. So to increase the conduction, we are adding doping. So we have to add some impurities. Which one I have to select the impurity? Only one thing. The impurity size, impurity size must be is equal to the intrinsic semiconductor, intrinsic semiconductor atom size. You take a intrinsic semiconductor. What is, sir, here I am taking? Germanium I taken. You take a impurity, you take another atom, that atom size must be is equal to this germanium atom size. If we have around 120 elements in our periodic table, in those, which one I have to select as a impurity? To understand that, here I am drawing a simple periodic table structure. If you go for germanium and silicon, where these are exists, sir? Germanium and silicon are in 14th table, 14th group. Germanium and silicon exists in 14th group. These exist in 14th group. These are the atoms. So we have to add some impurity. The impurity atom size must be equal to silicon atom size. The impurity atom size must be equal to germanium. That's why, which one you have to select? You have to select 13th group elements and 15th group elements. These 13th group elements and 15th group elements atom size nearly is equal to 14th group element. Here I am taking number of elements I have. You have here I am taking simple example as boron. Boron belongs to 13th group element. Boron atom size nearly is equal to silicon. You take for 15th group. One more example here I am taking phosphorus. Phosphorus atom size nearly is equal to silicon atom size. That's why, which one you have to choose as impurities? Impurities 13th group elements like boron, aluminium, their phosphorus, bismuth, like that. Here I am taking boron. If you observe a boron, boron belongs to 13th group. That's why it is chosen as a impurity. What is the atomic number, sir? Boron atomic number is 5. Right? Electronic configuration. Electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. What is the outermost orbital? Here outermost orbital is 2. In outermost orbital, how many electrons are there? 2 plus 1. In outermost orbital, I have 3 electrons. You go for phosphorus. You go for phosphorus. Phosphorus atomic number 15. I am writing electronic configuration. What is there? 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p. How much I have to write? See, 2 plus 2, 4. 4 plus 6, 10. 10 plus 2, 12. So here it is a 3. What is the outermost orbital? Outermost orbital number is 3. In outermost orbital, how many electrons are there? 2 plus 3. In outermost orbital, I have 5 electrons. In outermost orbital, I have 5 electrons for phosphorus, 3 electrons for boron. See, what's our here 13th group elements, all elements. In 13th group, every element has 3 electrons in outermost orbital. In 15th group, all elements have 5 electrons in outermost orbital. That's why these are called trivalent elements. Trivalent element. Tri means 3. And these are pentavalent elements. Penta means 5. Pentavalent elements. Then what about silicon and boron? As told you in the beginning, silicon and boron have 4 electrons in outermost orbital. These are tetravalent impurities, tetravalent elements, tetravalent elements. So silicon and germanium are semiconductors. These are having 4 electrons in outermost orbital. That's why these are called tetravalent elements. For these pure form of tetravalent element, I have to add impurities. That process is called doping. Why I have to dope, sir? Simple. If you dope, automatically conduction increases, current level increases. Which one we have to add? You can add either trivalent impurities or pentavalent impurities. If I add trivalent impurities, what happens? If I add pentavalent impurities, what happens? We have to check now. Okay, here I am using a trivalent. I am adding a trivalent impurity. Now I am adding trivalent impurity.